So I'm a staff writer for a women's magazine. I know what you're thinking. No, not that kind of women's magazine. We don't give life hacks on house cleaning, and we don't rank seasonal lip shades. I'm working on a personal essay on my circle of girlfriends. There's five of us, and we could not be more different. Our dating profiles would be quite interesting. Lauren Atwood, a real girl's girl, age 25, career, staff writer for Boss Bitch magazine. Motto, yes, we still can. Favorite movie, Thelma and Louise. When shit gets tough, Lauren believes in a combination of mindfulness, meditation, and creative teamwork. Relationship status.
Where are you going?
I have to go back to school.
No.
It's okay. It's okay.
Healthy and committed three-year relationship with Beau. He's currently teaching English.
Hey, babe. How's it going?
In Bulgaria.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm about to go. Yes.
These guys do exist.
Yeah, I miss you too.
Oh, and Frankie said to tell you that that's what you get for auto-drafting your fantasy league from Bulgaria. I love the shit out of you. Mwah. Then there's Frankie. Frankie Giffen. Age 27. Career. Software development. Motto.
Blood sugar. 103. Fucking killing it.
Frankie. Motto.
Choose sarcasm. Because beating the shit out of people is illegal.
Favorite movie? The Sandlot. Believes that a gnome sneaks into her room every night and steals socks and panties.
Seriously, where do they go?
Relationship status, single. Though she rarely swipes right, when she does, you're in for a good time.
Yep, right.
And Stacy Beals, age 24, career, hair and makeup artist. Motto.
I read it on Reddit. I mean, it's probably true.
Favorite movie? Hold please.
Halo.
Stace, what's your favorite movie?
Favorite movie?
Yeah, it's Clueless, right?
You're right.
Wait, you do know that Stacey Dash wanted to eliminate Black History Month, right?
I'm sorry, what?
Yep.
Stacey Dash wanted to eliminate Black History Month.
Mm-hmm.
How did I miss that? Unacceptable.
I know, right?
As if. Okay, new movie, Crooklyn. So many life lessons.
Got it.
Final answer, Crooklyn.
Favorite movie, Crooklyn. Comforted by the Kardashians. Relationship status, openly gay and ready to slay. Jillian Olsen, age 27. Career, former child star turned Real Housewife of West Nashville. Motto.
Family first. And yes, you can choose your family.
Favorite movie, Steel Magnolias. Comforted by her five dogs. Yes, they are rescues. And when shit gets tough, Jillian bakes cookies. Relationship status, married to country music superstar Michael Ray Black. Melissa Ruthers, today? HBIC girls. She is the definition of a career girl. Age 35, career, owns multiple commercial real estate properties.
Can you hold on a second?
Motto.
Work hard, play hard.
Favorite movie, The Devil Wears Prada. Comforted by every other Thursday night girls' night in. And when shit gets tough, Melissa never says, why me? She says, try me.
Amanda, you need to go take care of it and then don't call me again.
I swiped right and sent him home with leftover pizza. It's like, the least you could do is toss your shit to him.
Did you see the picture of Michael and Scene? He was with some ginger chick in LA last weekend.
His publicist is a redhead. And don't say ginger, it's racist.
I can't be racist. I have black friends.
Okay, well, it's like racist towards white people.
That's not a thing.
It's reverse racism.
Which means it's not racism.
Why are we having this argument?
Because you refuse to talk about what's really going on here. What is up with Jill and Michael? We have to get this out of Jill. She can't keep this stuff bottled up.
Okay, tabloids lie, Stace, and Jillian's private. Just let her be.
If you don't talk about your problems, they will kill you. I saw it on Dr. Oz. They will literally sit in your stomach and turn to cancer.
You don't think you're exaggerating just like
a little bit?
Yeah.
Yo. Mel.
It's Thursday, and what do we not do on Thursday?
I know.
That's
I know.
Right, real estate.
Mel. Hey, friends.
Hey.
Hey.
How's it going?
It's good.
Good. Where's Mel?
From the sounds of it, she's getting pretty riled up at Amanda. Also, who is Amanda, and why is she causing so much drama in my life right now?
You're so right. God, your life is so crazy. How do you do it day after day?
Shut up.
Okay. We need to do this now.
Yes, we could have done that like 20 minutes ago.
Amanda, you are being so annoying right now. I don't want to be hearing your voice.
How could you be so annoyed with me when I told you?
I know, but we do this every other Thursday. Not after 5 p.m. You know this. Why are we even having this conversation?
It's the language in the contract.
Right?
It needs
so a fix
minute.
It. That's your job, to fix it.
Bobby already left, Melissa.
Okay, then call him back.
Come on.
We talked about this like 4 times already, Amanda. Do you know what redundant means?
Do you know what
that's
this
what you're being.
Means?
No, it's a waste stream.
How about we change the name of these Thursday?
I'm sorry. You know what, Amanda? I'm going through a tunnel right now. I'm losing you. I'm losing you. Sorry,
hey,
girls.
Hey, ladies.
Hey.
Who the hell is this?
Oh, that's your sister. Merch didn't sell.
That's terrible artwork, so I bought them all.
Way to support.
I know, right? Jillian, sweetheart, I don't invite you over so that you'll clean. But I mean, if you insist.
Okay, Mel, I told you, these things are not biodegradable.
Yeah, but they make your bun look really big.
Okay.
Mel.
Yeah.
How do your pants still smell so good at the end of the day?
That's my pheromones. I had them adjusted to smell like Chanel No. 5.
Really?
Yeah. No, I'm not that rich. That's the pizzas.
Okay, but Mel, I'm not kidding. You know that thing in Texas that's it's littered with these and straws and panty liners.
Yeah, it's the size of Texas.
In the
ocean?
Oh.
Yeah. I know what you're talking about.
I don't know, whatever. The reef is dying.
Okay, girls, I have pizza. Okay, I just got one for each of you, or you can share, I don't care. Okay, veggie, no onions for you, doll. We have gluten-free, dairy-free. No, this is going in the trash can.
No.
Okay, fine. Canadian bacon with pineapple.
Yes,
well, that's done for you. So my little good. Meat lover.
Yes.
Supreme, all the meats.
All the meats.
Sorry.
Do you have any beer?
I am so sorry, Boo. I forgot to pick it up.
Oh, no Mick Ultra?
No.
No trash beer even?
Nope.
B-double-L's?
No.
Oh,
I hate beer. I'm sorry.
I don't want to drink wine. It makes my eyes cry.
Oh.
Okay, well, don't worry. We're not gonna drink wine. We're drinking tequila.
Yes, you are a goddess.
Right. You know what, ladies?
It's a moment.
Oh.
Yes.
Ooh, get it. Okay. Get it.
Hashtag poor choices Thursdays. Get over here, Belle. Get in here. Get in here.
Oh,
get in
okay.
Here.
Okay, I got the tequila. Hashtag poor choices Thursdays.
Take our phones.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, here we go.
Yay.
Yeah, they
all
sponsored right. Michael's last tour.
Ooh.
Oh,
I am okay with this.
How many inches? How many inches do you want?
Let me start.
Okay.
So what are we watching?
Okay, I say Bridget Jones' Diary. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Always want to watch that.
Well, first of all, she's my spirit animal. And second of all, you always want to watch Abby the Adolescent Witch.
Especially when Jillian's not here.
She's not supposed to know that. Thank you very much.
Guys.
Okay, hold on. You might always be Abby to the rest of America, but to us, you're just Jillian.
Mm. Yeah, I'll drink to that. To Jillian, who bakes his cookies, and not to Abby.
To Abby!
Rachel, I have a question for you.
Yeah?
Would you rather watch a year-long marathon of Abby the Adolescent Witch or star in a season of The Real Housewives of Nashville?
Absolutely, hands down, I would rather watch myself grow up on TV than expose my private life on air.
Pros.
You would never fit in on those shows anyway. You're just not bitchy enough, babe.
Oh, guys, I have a serious one, okay?
Go.
Would you rather have a very painful vaginal birth or completely pain-free, but through your mouth?
No.
Something is very wrong with you.
Okay, wait, hang on. Would I be able to dislocate my jaw like a python, then it just pops back in? How's this gonna work?
Exactly like a snake. Mouth or vag?
I mean, mouth, I guess.
Yeah, same.
I'm with you. You gotta protect the lady part.
Oh my God!
Oh my God.
have to film this.
Stacy, don't open the door, okay? Okay, we don't know what's in the air, all right? Keep that closed.
Is it a terrorist attack? Oh, my.
Close the curtain.
Okay. Oh, my God.
The curtain.
Oh, my God. Is it North Korea? What did he tweet? How am I supposed to know what's going on in the world? No. Do you have service?
No, I don't. Let
me see your phone.
No one has service.
It's okay. It's Mercury retrograde right now!
I can't be here. I gotta go.
Hey, hang on, okay? Stop. Look, no electricity. That means no elevators. We're not gonna run down 14 flights of stairs, okay? We don't know what's happening in that. We don't know what's happening.
She's right. I mean, it's dark in here, but...
Here.
And outside is fire and smoke and probably zombies and swine flu and real tank girl shit out there.
Wait, what?
Wait, why are people leaving?
Should we go?
No.
Everybody. All right, let's just calm down. Take a deep breath, okay? Do you have any flashlights or any candles?
Yeah. Come on, let's go. Okay, can you hold that?
Yeah.
Okay, can you guys just hold the light up for me so I can see?
What exactly are we looking for?
I have these lantern things I've never used. I invested in them when I was on Shark Tank. They're battery powered but partially run on solar or some shit, I don't know. Here, I'm gonna hand stuff out.
Okay.
I wish Greg was here.
Why?
He has all this stuff. He had a Head for the Hills bag, which is one of the many reasons we're not together anymore. Weirdo.
Where is Greg?
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say he's probably headed for the hills.
Oh, Mel, you guys were so in love.
Stacy, I can't with that right now, okay? We're still friends, we're just, God, this one's heavy. We're not an item anymore. But he is the reason that I have tons and tons of camping lights. The man loves camping.
Ooh. Thoughts?
Oh, that's actually...
Fashionable and practical.
Oh, look. Bingo.
That's what I was looking for. Those are battery powered, too.
Oh, Frankie. You can match. This works great.
Let there be light, ladies.
Whoa. It's okay, ladies.
Is that Greg?
It's okay.
What are you doing here? How did you even get in?
Well, if you must know, Miss Lady, I used my key. Look, it's pretty bad out there. They got attacks going on in San Francisco, New York, Nashville, and even Boise.
Boise?
God, somebody must really hate potatoes.
Oh, Frankie. How do you know all this?
Radio.
You have a radio?
Of course he has a radio.
Do you have a radio?
No, I don't have a radio. I mean, who has a radio anymore, right?
Greg has a radio.
Of course he has a radio.
Now you have a radio.
Here.
Look, someone needs to go fill up the tub, okay? Take advantage of this water while we still have it. Use all of the hot water.
On it.
And... seal up the windows. Make sure you seal up the edges. You don't want any of that outside air penetrating.
Penetrating what?
I can hear you.
I can't.
Come on, Jill.
Don't you think this is a bit much? Okay.
No.
Scare them. What are you doing here?
Came for my camping lights.
I told you we need some space, babe. Christ, I mean, what is this?
It's a gas mask.
Ant-Man or something?
Look, you knew I was coming back for you.
I do kind of like this look. I really love a man in a vest with lots of tiny pockets.
Yeah, I look pretty dangerous, huh? I figured you'd like it.
It's kind of sexy. Like, what are you putting here? Like, hand sanitizer wipes? You look like G.I. Joe. Who's St. Ogler?
Fantasy Superman. Plus, if we're gonna die, you know I wanna tap that ass one more time.
Oh my God, this sweet talk. Okay, babe.
No.
Okay, St. Ogler, just give me a second, okay?
Oh, tap that ass? Are you freaking kidding me?
Babe, just give me a second.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah, come on. Yeah, babe.
Bye, babe.
Get out.
Yeah,
go. Babe. You can't leave us.
So hold her down, I'll get the tape.
Melissa, you're not seriously considering this.
Okay. What happened to Miss Independent? You know, Hill would be so ashamed, okay? Come on, what happened to Miss On Her Own and Miss Solidarity and Friends and Kelly Clarkson? What? Please don't
okay,
go.
Look.
You all have healthy sex lives, and I haven't gotten laid in like 8 billion years. So if this really is the end of the world, Mama's gonna get a little vitamin D just one more time, okay? I gotta go before I change my mind, okay?
No,
I love you guys.
No,
okay,
no,
don't make me cry. I love you.
No.
I love you.
No,
be safe.
No,
be
no,
safe.
No, no.
Stay safe.
Bye.
Did that really just happen?
What a fucking whore. Is this a joke?
Melissa Ruthers, relationship status. It's complicated.
This is PJ and Mags, and we've interrupted our Thursday Night Americana countdown to bring you emergency news coverage. America is under attack. The following cities have been bombed: San Francisco, New York, Nashville, Orlando, and Boise.
Everyone is advised to stay where you are, seek shelter, tape and seal doors and windows, ration food and water. There have been no further attacks since 8:35 p.m. Central Standard Time. We do not know the extent of the threat, as toxicity levels cannot be determined at this time. We just got this in for Nashville and surrounding counties. All interstates are closed. Please do not attempt to leave or enter the greater Nashville area. All air travel has been suspended.
We can't listen to this all night. Okay. Let's do what he said. Right. Gather supplies and ration, okay? So we have 5 pizzas, right? And the fridge is gonna stay cold for a day or so. We've got hummus, pickles, 2 pudding cups, any condiment you could imagine.
That's it?
We have more pizza and penis ice. Let's see. We have Greg shit.
And Jillian's cookies.
Mm-hmm. And 5 dehydrated Greg meals. And if anyone's wondering, 154 units of insulin. Wait, how long is that gonna last?
5 days, maybe 7.
Okay, great, awesome. Right, we also have 1 case of electrolyte-infused waters. All right, so sip slow and make it last, ladies. All right? So we're gonna wait this out.
Okay. Oh, we need to rig up some lights.
Frankie, yes. Go team.
Get these panties popping. Busted AF.
It's actually pretty genius.
It's good.
Thanks. I haven't tuned into these in forever.
I know, just read it.
Please stand by for instructions.
We just got an update.
Reports of Ebola-like symptoms developing from exposure to the air and debris within what is now a 6-mile radius of the sites of attack.
Okay. All we can do is wait and pray.
If you are within a safe shelter, be advised that it could be days, even weeks, before rescue missions are attempted. Nashville is under martial law. Please do not open doors. There is a biochemical threat outside.
We are one of five American cities attacked tonight in seemingly unmotivated acts of terror. Stand strong, Music City.
Tell those around you love them.
All right, y'all, we're gonna continue taking calls and update you with information as it comes in. This is PJ with WBNA-FM.
Who am I speaking to?
This is Reverend Adam Schultz, and I just want all the cities in America to know that the prayer warriors are going strong. My daughter is in Nashville. If you hear me, darling, you know you need to get right with God because your chance of survival is not good.
Nope.
That was the Reverend. You can catch him on Sundays.
There's Cam.
Should we go with her? Probably. First one to separate is usually the first one to die.
It's usually the black person.
Not in this house.
Yeah, we're woke.
Please don't ever say that again.
Okay. God, to whoever's watching, please go to my notes, and under the file, it's titled Worst Night Ever. You will find my very last article. It's my very last article that's gonna document what just might be our very last night on Earth. Sorry, there have been Black Hawks and circling. Anyways, please, if you see this, get it to Boss Bitch Magazine, okay? If that's still a thing. You hear it? Shaking. Anyways, so please just get it to Boss Bitch Mag if you can. And to Bo, baby, if you see this, hope you know I love you. I love you so much. I really do. And I'm pregnant. Oh my God, no, I'm not. I'm just kidding. That was so bad. That was a bad joke. Very inappropriate bad timing. Not, you know me. Not that funny. Ha ha ha. Make myself laugh. And you by doing that. Anyways, whatever. I love you. I love you so much.
Is anyone else watching Abby the Adolescent Witch on TV?
Bridget Jones' Diary.
E True Hollywood Story.
Of course.
Oh. Fuck it, y'all. I'm taking the good stuff.
Why did the siren stop? I don't know, Jill.
I'm really scared.
I know. Me too.
There's nothing we can do.
We're just gonna have to face the fact that we're probably gonna die in the next few days, either from starvation or opening up a window and dying from some bleeding eye shit.
Oh, God. Oh, don't cry, Jill. Just drink. At least you're with us. Frankie?
No, makes my eyes cry.
Fine.
Okay, listen. I just want to say that this room is a safe space. All right, so whatever is weighing on your hearts, just let it out, okay? Because if we're gonna die with clean consciences.
And there will be no judgment, just understanding and solidarity.
Thank you, Brene.
What time is it, March?
Funny, Frankie.
No, but seriously, I want to roll my eyes at everything you say, but... Oh, but I can't. Because I really do feel like I'm in a safe space with really supportive friends.
Oh, you are.
I just wish you were a little more de facto feminist.
Oh, fourth wave. Sorry, boo.
It's okay. I'm still happy.
Thanks, Frank.
It's got to be freeing, though, to not have to write another girl power article if this is the end.
You know what? I actually really love my job. I do. I was in the middle of writing a piece right now, actually, sort of based on all of us. I don't know. I feel like I need to finish it, you know, especially now.
A eulogy.
Shit.
Yeah. Well, if anyone's going to eulogize us, it should be you, Lo.
Thanks, Rachel.
Jill, why don't we ever do this at your place? Would we, like, disturb Michael's process? I know you live a ways out, but I can't help but think if we would have been there.
Because Melissa's here, like, twice a month, and we can all Uber downtown. I mean, plus my house isn't very homey, you know. Sometimes I feel like we bought it just for the Southern Living photo shoots.
Where is Michael tonight?
He's in Colorado. I wonder if he knows what happened. I haven't talked to him today.
Wait. At all?
No. It's been a little rough lately. Yeah, I mean, I'm not even sad right now. I'm just having some regrets.
Because you were trying to get pregnant.
I mean, yes. No. I really just... I wanted to feel needed.
Fuck, Jill.
I mean, why else do you think I have 5 dogs?
That is a little excessive.
Hey. You know what, Joe?
None of that matters.
Why? Do you know why?
Why?
Because you make the best cookies in the whole world.
Did that just come out of your butt?
No, I'm not kidding.
So gross.
No. Wait, are you storing cookies under the couch?
No.
They lost the day.
That would be insane.
Hey, she's saving that whip for later.
Can I have some?
No. Jill, you have nothing to regret. You know, like, God, look at how much you've done. I mean, look at what you've overcome.
Hold, please. What exactly did you overcome? Were you an addict? Was it coke?
Stacy.
97.8% of child stars go to Betty Ford. Fact. Were you a sex addict?
Really?
Did you have trichotillomania?
What? Did you just make that up?
No, Stacy. She brought cookies for fuck's sake. She doesn't have an eating disorder.
What? I'm just saying, we've never dived into this. What the hell else are we gonna talk about?
Wait, seriously, what is trichotillomania?
It's when you pull your hair out.
Oh. Yeah, I totally had that.
Really?
No.
Jill's got jokes,
yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. Don't do that again.
Oh.
Wait, come back. Yeah,
hold on, Stace. I need to get some Advil or something.
What's Flexeril?
Oh, it's a good time in a bottle.
Hey, I hear you in there. Open the door. I need help. Open the door, please. I won't hurt you.
Please help me. I need help. I can hear you in there. Open the door, please. I need help right now, please.
Just give him a bottle of water. You can take one of mine.
No.
Open the door, please. I'm not going to hurt you. I need help. Please, let me in.
Hey, what's your name?
Will.
Will, I'm Lauren.
Lauren?
Please let me in. I'm not gonna hurt you. I just need water. It's not for me, I swear.
Will, did you open a window?
No. I said don't open the window. Don't stop. Fuck!
Open the door.
open the fucking door! I'll kick the fucking door! I'll kick it in right now! Open the fucking door! Open the door!
Oh my god.
Will, go back to your apartment and I'm gonna call for help, okay?
1402.
What?
Apartment 1402.
Okay, I gotta see this too. Oh, that's some 28 days later shit.
Will?
That'll do. Will. Frankie!
Tape. Watch out, though.
Hey, you okay? Come on, let's take a minute, right? Hey, we'll be right back. Come on. Just take a breath, okay? Hey. Just put your hands behind your head, okay? Come on, and breathe in, all right? Okay, breathe in. Go. 3, 4. Okay, do it again. 3, 4. You got it.
Lauren, that guy outside is gonna die any minute, and I just watched you lie to him to calm him down, and now you're doing that to me.
Whoa, hey. I'm not lying to you, okay? You are okay. Stacy's gonna sanitize the hell out of that door, all right? You know her. You might not get any fresh air for a while, but... You're not dying tonight, Jill. Okay.
Okay. This bed is ridiculously comfortable.
See? Silver lining.
A little bit.
Maybe. Tiny.
It's there. Did you want to try and get some sleep or have some time to yourself?
No, I don't want to be left alone.
Okay. What can I do for you, Jill?
I need some happiness up in here. Tell me a joke.
Okay. Okay, on a scale of 1 to Frankie, how offensive do you want it?
Surprise me low.
Okay. Okay, are you ready? What do gay horses eat?
Hey.
Oh, yeah, girl. Okay. What do lesbian horses eat?
I don't know.
Right.
Hey. What was that?
It's my party trick.
Oh, nice G-force.
It's funny, right? It's good.
I hate to break up this flap gathering, but our friend Stacy here is going to have an aneurysm if she doesn't hear the true Hollywood story of Jillian Olsen in the next 20 minutes.
Please! What is a flap gathering?
Frankie?
It's two or more vaginas. Figure it out, Jill. You'll get it.
I'll show you later.
I'm gonna need another drink.
Yeah, that I can do. Some nosy rosies. Can't have
give me the goods, bitches. Guys, what the fuck? Whose is this? Stacy?
Why do you assume it's me?
Because you read this trash.
And that's all it is, Jill, is trash.
I didn't get it because Michael was on the cover. I got it because Kylie was. You know I love her.
Is it true?
Yes. It's been fucking his publicist the past year. Where's my glass?
Oh, shit.
the name y'all fucked him?
What?
No.
Why would you ask that?
Frankie?
Gross. Why would you single me out like that? I'm not in the least bit attracted to Michael, okay? You know I like black guys, right?
Rule number one, you don't fuck your friend's boyfriends. God, Jill, get a grip.
I would never do that, okay? You guys are seriously my only girlfriends, and I am loyal as fuck, okay? And it's always been like that. Most women just don't like me.
Newsflash, it's because you always flirt with our fellas.
Whoa. What?
Yeah, you do.
I mean, you always tell Michael how much you love the songs, and you sing every word, and you talk about how great they are, and, like, puff them up.
That's because I like his music.
Sorry, what? How? Like, I don't even like it.
Okay, so shoot me if I think Bro Country is catchy, Jillian. Okay, everybody likes Cruz, and if they say they don't, they're lying.
You flirt with Bo, too.
Okay, Stacey, not helping. Hey, I watched Sunday Night Football with Bo, for fuck's sake.
Hey, Frankie, it's fine, okay? Calm down. God, all right, listen. I have never felt threatened by you watching football with Bo, okay? Honest to God. You two could sleep in the same bed together, okay? And I wouldn't care because I trust you both, all right? And that's what's really wrong here. Jill, you don't trust Michael. Okay, and you're misplacing that on our very dear friend, Frankie, right now, okay? So, Frankie, hey. 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 It's not your fault. Okay?
This makes so much sense. Girls don't like me because I get along with their men better than they do.
It's true.
Okay, y'all. I just tell y'all something. Y'all know I was raised by my dad and brothers, okay? So here's some safe space shit for you. I know I mentioned that I was bullied, but I don't know if I ever really mentioned how bad it was, okay? Because it was really bad, okay? Kids are fucking cruel, and but my brothers looked out for me, okay? And when they got tired of seeing me get off the bus every day crying, they just took me with their crew. And, you know, they stood up for me. And they taught me how to stand up for myself. And I became the little sister of the entire West Side football team, okay? Clear eyes, full hearts, and Frankie. Can't lose. So cheerleaders started coming up to me, okay, to get closer to the guys. Roles changed, y'all. And the one thing I learned, and I still stand by today, damn it, is that men treat you as an equal if you just learn the offsides rule.
Praise. Okay?
I climbed the social ladder because I toughened up. Hey, this is me. Take it or leave it. I can hang with the boys and I can hang with the girls. I can watch the Titans or Bridget Jones' Diary. I can do both, and that's great. And it's okay. It doesn't mean I want your man's dick, okay? Jesus.
I'm sorry. Please don't cry, Frankie.
You fucking stop crying.
Okay.
Hey. Hey, you two. Hug it out.
Hug it out.
Are you okay, Jill?
Sorry, y'all.
You're freaking me out. She's got the crazy eyes.
I'm just, like, taking it all in. This is it. This is not how I thought I'd go. It's not gonna be quick, is it? I'm gonna go to the bathroom. I just need a minute.
Thank you. Safe shelters are being set up, and once they open, we will inform you. For now, do not exit any buildings. Let's take one more call. This is WBNA Nashville. You got PJ Weller.
Hi, I'm Sloan, and we're in the building. No one's coming, are they? Why isn't anyone sending help? People can't see. We can't breathe.
Holy fucking shit. Hey, I'm gonna go surface the bed for a little bit. Okay. I just need to clear my head.
Do what you gotta do, Lo. We're not going anywhere.
You don't wanna go to 80s night?
Oh, hi. I'm Shannon. I am your husband's new publicist, Shannon. We're gonna be good pals. You're just so beautiful. Oh, beautiful my ass. Compared to your dumb bitch face and your dumb bitch fake hair. Probably clip-in extensions. You don't even have titties. Screw you, Shannon.
No.
Fuck you. Fuck you, Shannon. Fucking redheads. Can you fucking get away from them? I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Peyton. Probably really nice.
Okay, I'm back.
This sucks. This fucking sucks. It sucks. Oh my god. Bo. I wish you were here. Oh, I wish you were here. Next time, if you want to go fishing, baby, I will go fishing with you. I promise. You know that I love the outdoors. I do. I don't want to bait the hook, you know? But, I mean, I will climb up whatever little mountain you want. I will wear Tevas for God's sakes. That feels so good right now. I'm okay. I'm okay. There's not enough yoga on this planet that can prepare me for tonight. But baby, I am okay. Ooh.
Stacy, you know there aren't cell towers by the dishwasher.
I didn't build a grid. I don't know where the signals are.
Oh, this is fucked.
This is so fucked. This is call Bruce Willis and Liam Neeson fucked. And the Avengers, and the Justice League.
Sure, just mix the universes.
And the Power Rangers.
Oh, hell yes. Hey, what's this? Do you smell something? It was like fresh flowers.
That scents all 26. Of course, Melissa has Lalabo candles. I want one in here. If we're gonna die, we're gonna smell amazing.
What the heck? What are you doing? That was our drinking water.
I'm not interested in what you're saying.
What in the actual fuck, Jillian?
You do know those candles are worth like $100 a piece.
Really?
Well, they are.
That explains a lot. They smell amazing.
I'm taking them.
Wait, what? What's going on?
Lo.
I'm reading your article on long distance love. You're incredible. I'm sorry I never read your magazine. I'm a bad friend.
Jillian.
You just bath bombed our drinking water. You are the worst friend. I mean, are you trying to kill us?
We're gonna die anyway.
We're gonna die a lot faster now, you asshole.
I'm doing us a favor.
Get out of the tub, I'm throwing you off the balcony.
No, just wait. You can fend for yourself in Chernobyl, Jillian.
She's gonna go angry cry now. You just pissed off white Oprah.
Ugh, please.
You know, fuck you, Jillian.
Oh, shut up.
You know, I hope you choke on a dick and die.
Where exactly does one find a dick in the apocalypse?
You know what? When I find one, I'm gonna shove it down your selfish throat.
I look forward to it.
Same.
No, it really isn't. Jillian's a bitch, okay? And you have been nothing but amazing to all of us.
You've held it together all night. You deserve to fall apart if you need to.
I just need to hang on to a little hope, y'all. Like, just the slightest possibility of us surviving this. Because I can't handle the thoughts in my head right now.
What are you thinking?
That I'm never gonna see Bo again. My mom. My family. What happens if you run out of insulin?
I mean, Bella's gonna have to put up with some shit.
Oh my God, is it gonna be like Shelby?
No, I am not gonna be like Shelby. I fucking hate that movie.
That's Jillian's favorite movie.
Oh, well, fuck Jillian. The only thing awesome in that movie is Dolly Parton.
Praise.
It's still gonna be... Oh, not okay.
I'm not mad at Jillian.
Well, that makes one of us.
Me neither. What's the point?
She's just sad. You know, I'm sad too. And if bath bombs make her feel better, then I'm glad that she did it.
Flo, you amaze me. You, like, can't stay mad at anybody.
What's the point?
Fair point. Guys, nobody's mad at you. Seriously. What's the point?
What's the point?
Oh, I thought I broke you.
Don't flatter yourself. The potato haters broke her.
Still want to throw me off the balcony?
A little bit.
God, those candles do smell really good, though.
Right?
Mom. Do you want a cookie?
Relax. She's going to get the cookie.
Oh my God. So good.
I'm starting to think you guys only keep me around for my cookies.
Yeah, because you're happy.
Duh. Hey. I hate to interrupt the Cooter conference here. I just wanted to make sure you guys are okay. 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 Cool. So. So what are you guys doing in here? Just hanging out, eating a cookie, meditating on the toilet?
Yes, Frankie.
because I typically meditate on the toilet, not on a silk poof in my beautifully designed home yoga studio. Oh, that's a good look.
Where's Stacy at?
When I left, she was spooning the refrigerator looking for signal.
I will get a signal.
That girl is nothing if not determined.
Frankie, I never thought that you slept with Michael. You know I didn't mean it, right?
Yeah, we're all good. Just moving on. And don't make it weird. Don't make it weird.
Thank you, Pat. Would you stay strong for those boys?
Burned your hair?
Let's take one more time. We're speaking with.
Hi, this is.
You had literally one job.
I'm calling, hoping Meg's girlfriend hears me. I don't even know what time it is there. Lo, if you hear me, there's no planes allowed to fly into the U.S. right now. I'm sorry I can't be there. Don't be scared. I know you're not. If I know you, you're keeping everyone around you calm. I'm at Besmer Air Base. We're listening constantly. I'm coming home as soon as I can. I love you, Lauren. I'll see you soon.
Lauren, if you're listening, your fella loves you. And stay strong, honey.
See? Not everyone's losing it.
Well, Lauren's got her hands full.
This fucking night.
I have a signal! I have a signal!
What? You do?
Fuck! False alarm! False alarm! Do y'all think Mel has weed?
Melissa did invest in solar vapor technology.
That is not a real thing.
Yeah, it is. It's like the future. Yeah. Space weed. Oh, wait. I know just where to look for weed. Hold, please.
Oh, my God. Melissa, how many of these shirts did you buy? Oh my God. Shut up. Oh, Jackpot. Melissa, what a class act. Flavor is this? Purple pajama.
I think you mean blue dream.
That'll work. I have a really good idea.
What?
What if you don't braid my hair and you more just tussle it?
Is that tussling? Who says tussle?
Just tussle. Like just hard, harder, harder.
Harder?
Slower.
Slower?
Oh.
I feel so much better. Right?
I've never been high before.
Seriously?
Y'all never pushed?
Of course not.
I assumed every child star had tried coke past the age of puberty.
Nope. I've always just been scared.
Of weed?
Of everything.
Well, I am totally stoked. The first time you did it is with us.
Hashtag me too.
No.
I mean, I am relaxed, y'all.
I mean, I'm still scared, but I'm okay. It's beyond my control.
Weed makes you rational, Jill.
We're gonna fight Hangman?
No. No, you know that piece I told you I was writing about? Piece I was writing for next month? Yeah.
Anyways, now, I just feel like I really need to finish it, and my battery's about to die, so I'm gonna get a copy on paper, you know?
Yeah, well, my phone's already dead.
I left my phone at home.
What?
What are you gonna do?
Look, we need to talk about this.
This is what keeps eating at me. When we die, does it hurt?
Where did you get that?
You know what? I bet Mel has enough muscle relaxers to where we could just make a cocktail and go to sleep.
If you really want to make it quick, she's got a gun.
Excuse me, what?
Oh, yeah.
I hate to break it to you, Loeb, but our friend Mel is a Republican.
No.
Yes.
No way.
I hate her.
No, you don't. She's one of your very best friends.
Who left us to die with nothing but pizza and a gun?
Okay, well, she said have at it. Mel wanted to get some D. Girl needed to be dicked down before she died. You gotta respect her for owning that shit.
And you're not alone.
Yeah. We're gonna die together. With pizza.
And a gun. See?
And Stace, now do you see why Mel didn't use social media? It's because it was better when we didn't know our friends' political and religious beliefs, you know? Things were just easier. There is a beauty in the unity that it can create. You know, I mean, it's freaking amazing that we can still keep in touch with our friends, you know, on the other side of the world. Oh my God. But it also sincerely and tremendously damages interpersonal connections and relationships, you know? Sometimes I wish I had an off button for this verbal diarrhea, but pot just makes me wax intellectual. It's catch 22.
Yeah, okay. Where'd you get that chocolate?
Right here. You just like open up a drawer and chocolate appears.
See, check it.
And in her heart, she voted for Hill, okay? You let me have that.
Hold, please. Where's the gun? I need to know. Statistically, I'm the most likely to get shot.
No one's gonna shoot you.
Yeah. No one ever plans on shooting black people. That shit just happens.
Okay, no one is gonna shoot you, Stacy. No one is shooting anyone.
What if I asked you to? Would you shoot me?
No.
Okay. Settles it.
Okay, Stacy, I do have a serious question for you, though.
Hashtag safe space?
Sure. Yeah, that's fine. Stacy, has your mom got it going on?
Oh, yeah, okay. Like, I've never heard that one before. You know what? This is one of those songs that all white people love. All of you. You love that shit. Get off of me.
Sorry, dance to it in eighth grade.
No, I didn't.
Signal?
Oh, no. I'm almost dead. Well, the phone, not me. Not yet. No, I was just looking at pictures of my mom. We normally talk every day, and of course today we didn't.
She knows. Moms have that kind of instinct.
How old were you when you lost your mom?
I had just turned 4 the week before the accident. And I have the vaguest memory of her. I was sick, and she came in and put a cold cloth on my head when I had a fever. And she had these big blue eyes and said, "Everything's gonna be okay."
That is the sweetest thing I have ever heard come out of your foul mouth.
What about you, Stace? You never talk about your mom.
We don't talk much.
Why not? I mean, who is Stacy's mom and does she have it going on?
Stacy's mom is a very religious woman from the Ninth Ward. She used to be married to a pastor and a gay daughter was too much to deal with.
You have a gay sister?
Jill, I am so proud. You, I'm seeing a lot of growth. If I had a gold star, I would give you one.
Go on, Stace.
Okay, so my mom ended up divorcing my dad over it. They were always fighting over me, so I perpetuated it.
What do you mean?
I would always embellish to see how far I could push them. I know it's fucked up, but y'all probably think I'm a terrible person, huh?
No. I think you were a kid who needed attention.
I appreciate that. But look, y'all, being gay is one thing, but being Black and gay in the South, that shit's not okay. Not yet. It's just a recipe for scrutiny. And I know my mom loves me. That's why she left my dad, but I just...
Okay, strictly speaking, from a third party outside objective observer journalistic perspective, it sounds to me like your mom wants to have a relationship with her daughter, but she's too afraid to challenge the patriarchal traditions under which she was brought up. Under. Up under.
Right? Yeah, that sounds about right.
Is that it?
Strictly speaking, from a journalistic perspective, you ended that sentence with like 19 prepositions.
Oh my God, I know. Fuck, y'all, weed kills my grammar.
Also, I have something clean, conscious, and coming. I've had a crush on Frankie for years.
Me?
Yes, this makes so much sense to me.
I'm flattered, Stace, but I know I'm not the girliest of girls, but I do still like the P and the B.
I know. I just admire you. You don't care what other people think. I care so much, I hide. And I lose myself in other people's lives. Other people's drama means I don't have to focus on mine.
That's heavy, Stace. And how did you come to that conclusion?
Therapy.
You know what? Fuck it. Come on.
What?
You think I want Tender Todd to be my last kiss?
Gross.
No, you know what? You never know. Never tried it.
Are you serious?
Educate me.
Okay.
Oh my God. That was so cute.
So, should we make out?
No, hun. No, you are just very high.
Yeah. Okay.
Are we, like, supposed to go in a closet?
I'm never going back in the closet.
So, have you ever slept with a man?
Nope.
Are you still a virgin?
No, Frankie, I'm not a virgin.
Who did you lose your virginity to?
Tell me. Since when do you want all the juicy details?
You're rubbing off on me. Kiss and tell.
I'll never forget it. I still have the box it came in.
Oh my God, you just made Lauren so proud. You have to tell her. With Beau in Bulgaria, she is all about taking care of yourself.
Oh, you met with another person. Yeah, I've done that too. Her name was Grace Starring, and I was 17.
Where were you?
De-gayification camp. I wish I was making that shit up.
Oh my God, I love you so much. That is fantastic. All right, lay one on me.
Jeez, Frankie, you're so romantic.
You gonna kiss me or not?
Okay. So, I'm like really good at it. You should be warned. I'm not trying to convert you, but it's happened. You should know this.
Please.
Frankie Giffen relationship status, update, by Curious.
Y'all are gonna wanna kiss Stacy before you die. And we don't have much time left, so you're gonna wanna go ahead and make a line.
A line of two people.
Boom!
Too soon?
A little bit.
I have a question. Would you rather...
No.
No, just humor me, okay? It's the end of the world. Would you rather have a very, very sensitive scrotum hanging from your chin or shit out of your ear?
It only gets worse. Every fucking time.
It's a rare talent.
Somebody sees a genius?
Oh, yeah? Okay, well, what if he sharted out of your ear? You know, you go...
I found the gun.
What the fuck, okay. Jillian?
All right, you know what? Jill, why don't you just give that to me?
Why? I'm not gonna shoot anybody.
Wait, Jill. Jill, give Frankie the gun.
You guys always treat me like a fragile little lamb. I am not unstable.
No, yes, you saying are. That. Just give a gun in your hand. So just, hey, give it to Frankie.
Just
hey,
give it to me.
You're about to see
please.
The beast.
Fuck. Screw you guys.
Unleash the beast.
Is that fun?
Okay, all right. Oh, my God.
Okay.
Just drop it. God. Jillian. What if there's people down there?
Me too.
Hello?
What if the windows are open down there? Jillian, you're letting poisonous air in.
It was an accident.
Oh, my God, we need to seal those, okay? Somebody find something. Other than your ass, Frankie. I have a dildo.
I have washi tape. I have Lysol.
Peen. Tape.
Praise.
Don't trip on it.
Don't shoot anything else.
I won't. I'm sorry.
We should light it for safety.
No, I'm sorry.
No, don't.
It's fine. Were there more bath bombs?
Yeah. There was 3 or 4 more.
Was the water still warm?
It was hot. It's probably still warm.
Okay, so I am gonna go put another bath bomb in what is now strictly our flushing water, and I'm gonna soak in it, and don't make a thing out of it.
Gross.
No, it's not gross. Shitting out of your ear is gross. Plus, Jill doesn't have cooties, and if you cut out the would you rather questions, I might let you go after me.
Yeah, hard pass.
Four Women in the End by Lauren Atwood. It's a Thursday night. Every other Thursday night is Girls Night In. My circle of friends, we meet up at our dear friend's condo. It's a safe space. We gossip, we confide, we cherish these Thursdays in Nashville. Tonight, Music City was one of 5 American cities attacked. We don't know why, we don't know who. Not yet. We may never know. There's sickness, there's fear. We're on the 14th floor of a high rise, and it's almost Christmas. The building is half empty, and some people panicked and ran outside. The walls rattled as they stampeded like a wild herd down the stairs. But others like us stayed put, because outside the air is too toxic to breathe. We are terrified, but we are not alone. There's our domestic darling.
She used to be a child star, and she always brings us homemade snickerdoodles. And she wants a baby, though she never had one. But she's in a place where she can share this, and nobody judges her. Instead, we rave about her baking skills. And we tell her we love her, because we do. There's our guy's girl. We are her only girlfriends. We trust her. She makes us laugh with her weird humor. Occasionally, she'll show her soft side because she knows that she can around us. And she's unapologetically herself. And for that, we applaud her. And we tell her we love her, because we do. Like every group, we've got a drama queen. Our drama queen loves to gossip. And since we've come to terms with our own mortality, we've learned a lot about each other tonight. We listen to her stories. We share her heartbreak. We indulge her. We accept her. We even tolerate the Kardashians. And we tell her we love her, because we do. Our career girl owns more property than all of us combined. She's the definition of a boss bitch. And this isn't the first time that I've written about her. She makes time for us every other Thursday as we invade her condo. She orders a feast, she turns off her phone, she vents, she brags, and she encourages us all to be the best that we can be. Tonight she left us and she went to be with her lover. You may never see her again, but she left us with food and water, an emergency radio, 4 Lalabo candles, and a ridiculously comfortable bed. We're not mad. We want her to be happy. And we tell her that we love her because we do. Then there's me. I write articles like this to show that as women, we can't fix the world and we can't fix each other, but we can make a difference. There's a power that's really hard to describe at play here. You know, it happens when women refuse to compete with each other, and instead we lift each other up. We listen, we commiserate, we collaborate, we empathize, we sympathize, and damn it, we survive. A while back, talks of an all-female reboot of Lord of the Flies was circulating Hollywood. Twitter blew up with responses and confusion. How the hell was that supposed to work? Some said that it would just be women sitting around apologizing to each other till they're dead. After tonight, I can see why. See, this is the all-female version of Lord of the Flies, except our desert island is a condo in a Nashville high-rise. And still, we are not taking sides. Instead, we're doing what my favorite tweet said about the reboot, and it may not be exact, and I don't have power to check my sources, but stand close. And I quote, "An all-female Lord of the Flies could never work. There would be no conflict, and it would essentially become the island that Wonder Woman grew up on." Hell yeah, it would. So, when the dust finally settles and the air clears, maybe this is paradise. Who knows what will rise from these ruins? One thing that I do know is there's 4 of us left on the island, and there's no Jack here, no Ralph or Simon or Piggy, but there's certainly more than one Wonder Woman. What do you think?
You made her eyes cry.
Oh, Frankie, don't cry. Oh, my God.
I can't believe that no one is going to see that print. Oh, my gosh.
I have to get it to Boss Bitch.
You have to get it to the radio station.
You have to. Yeah. I love you guys.
I love you, too.
Me, too. I love you guys, too.
Man. Hey, you guys want to try and get some sleep? It's getting kind of cold, huh?
Yeah.
Would anyone like to explain why there's a very large penis taped to my kitchen floor?
What are you doing here?
Why do you have to admit?
dude, that was pretty good.
It wasn't funny.
No!
What are you doing here?
Homework.
Well, number one, I live here. And two, you didn't think I was gonna leave you girls behind, did you?
Well?
No! Yeah. No, I have a lesbian level love for you girls. You know this.
So does Stacy.
And maybe Frankie.
What, meh? What do you mean, meh? Scoot over. Get out of my bed. Get out of my bed.
Don't let her in.
Really cozy.
So how was the D?
Yes, details.
Oh, lady never tells.
Oh, come on.
Nothing happened.
We cuddled and ate an MRE.
You cuddled to get back glow from a cuddle.
Standard cuddle glow.
SCG. Okay, we have this plus a few more gallons of water. It's all Greg shit. He said we should just take it. Chicken pesto pasta.
Where is he?
I have no idea. He wouldn't tell me where he was going, and I couldn't go with him. I want to hide in a bunker. Gross.
You have service?
No, I was just checking.
I don't think so.
You still have battery? Oh, yeah. These Shark Tank lanterns have USB cords.
What?
Yeah. Oh. Hey, did you guys get the radio to work? Have you been listening to what's going on?
Some shit's depressing.
Hey, if we ration, we have enough for a week. They're saying a rainstorm's coming tomorrow, which is gonna help clear the air. And then in a few more days, they're gonna start rescue missions.
Wait, really?
Really.
How many people died?
A lot, Jilly. A lot of people. But all we can do is wait, okay? It's not gonna be easy, but we just have to wait.
Was there a dead guy in the hall?
Just, like, don't think about that, okay? Don't think about that stuff. It's okay. It's okay.
You think you were exposed?
I think we've pretty much all been exposed through the air vents.
Fuck, why didn't I think to cover the vents? I think you sprayed enough Lysol to save us all.
Damn right I did. Here's the thing, guys. We've done absolutely everything we can. I mean, Greg and I stayed up all night cleaning the entire hallway in full rubber suit. And I learned a life lesson that you're only ever one rubber suit adventure away from fitting in your skinny jeans. So, do I look thinner?
Yeah, I feel amazing.
Here's the deal, guys, okay? There's 25 units in the building that still have tenants. We cleared out Greg's entire storage unit. We distributed all of his supplies evenly among the tenants. He took enough for himself, and then we brought the rest here. So it's just all we can do.
You never left the building?
No.
Wait, so you were up all night distributing supplies to your tenants?
Yeah.
I'm so proud to know you right now.
I mean, the captain can't jump ship, right? Hey, I was just doing my job. And plus, I love you guys. There was no way in hell I was gonna leave you behind.
Correction. This is the All-Female Dead Poet Society. Oh, captain, my captain. Oh, captain, my captain. Yes! Yes!
I know what you guys are thinking, and I am not standing on a chair. This is more of that shit white people love.
We do love it. We love that shit.
Mm-hmm. Well, how can we help? No.
I think it's all done. Oh, you guys can help me hang sheets.
What do you mean?
Come on.
We're going now to Mayor Stills of Nashville.
Good morning, everyone. Nashville remains under martial law. We ask that no one within eyesight of impact step outside until further notice. If you are alive and safe, please display white material in your windows. If you can write a number of people, please do so. If there is injury or need of medical attention, please mark with an X. If you are in need of water, please mark with an H. A winter storm is due to hit Nashville tonight. When the storm clears, we will continue to survey the damage and attempt to begin rescue missions. Stay strong, stay safe. Hunker down, tape your windows, and let us know you're alive. Government teams are working around the clock to restore power and communication. I'm not taking any questions at this time.
Guys, all of this cake reading is destroying my blood sugar.
Oh, that's insane.
Ooh, speaking of cake, Melissa, I've got one for you.
Yeah. Okay, shoot. Okay. I can't wait for this.
Would you rather sit on a dick and eat a cake or sit on a cake and eat a dick?
Well, it's entirely dependent on whose dick.
Jamie from Outlander's dick.
Ooh.
That's a good one. Is he in a kilt?
Duh.
Okay, but wait. Where is this uncircumcised Outlander penis going when you sit on it?
Ah, very important.
Very important.
Up the butt.
Oh. Of course. Oh, no. Of course it is up the butt.
Fuck that. I would sit on a cake and eat a dick.
Yeah. Jillian, everyone.
Oh, yeah. Jillian? No, Jillian is a new woman now, Mel.
Oh, my God.
Sweet little Jilly.
Sweet Jillian, not so sweet anymore.
You got her. Somebody get the woman some cake.
Thank you.
Okay, girls. Here we go.
I'm gonna go sleep in my room. I'll take one of you, or two if you're lucky. You can rock, paper, scissors that shit, or alternate nights or whatever, I don't care. But I get 1 hour alone. And I like to be the little spoon.
That's fair. So. Pris.
Oh. All right, everybody. As information becomes available, we will continue to share. But me and Mags here. I'm sorry, y'all. Here at WBNAFM, we are not here to scare you. We're sending out all of our thoughts and prayers. We're with you, Nashville. Tonight I just might play some more music again. In fact, this little band stopped by yesterday.
Camel Station.
It's just one of those songs I think we could all use right now. What do you think, Max?
I couldn't agree with you more, PJ. Let's hear it.
You gonna go lock yourself in the bathroom and write?
Hell no, it's way too cold in there.
Well, too cold out here. Hurry back.
You hurry.
I've been told when I fight, I'm not very ladylike. I recall all the times I had no other choice. I use my words, but you don't hear a thing. Underneath your ocean, I can't. Show you my lady like, oh.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. I just don't care.
I'm sorry, what? Stacey Dash wanted to eliminate slavery.
Nope.
Seriously.
Yeah, that wedgie right there. Let's pick that wedgie out.
Hey, I hate to break up this taco fest, but hate to break up this clam jam here. Hate to break up this episode of The View, but I hate to break up the titty committee here, but I hate to break up this flap gathering, but
what are you doing? That's our bathwater in there.
Nope.
Back up. What did I say?
That's our bath water. That's our bath water in there.
Pain.
For some reason, that run just got me.
There's 25 units, you guys, with tenants to sleep.
And that's okay. And it doesn't mean I want to suck.
Strictly speaking from an outside of, strictly speaking from an outside perspective, strictly speaking from, it sounds to me like your mom is yearning.
Hate to break down the beaver dam here. Storm the beaver lodge.
I'm like, you want to come in and everyone's going.
Yours from like another
planet. Your vagina?
I have. Have you? You stick a mirror down there.
I try to avoid it at all costs. It doesn't make any appearances.
I just wear a mirror. I just wear a mirror.
You just wear it
to happen. So we could wear that outfit.
Click.
Sorry.